destruction in America based upon a white suburban formula that was symbolized by the Levitts and others who built Levittown, New Jersey, Levittown, Pennsylvania.
So the Jews did that too.
No, I'm saying a whole policy.
So the Jews are responsible.
You. You cannot back up from the special
the
focus you give to
talking
this.
About the formula of suburbia in America. It was not a Jewish phenomenon. There were Irish involved.
Well,
there were Italians involved.
But why
was America was involved
that?
In creating white suburbs? And so I'm saying you cannot take two youngsters who gave their life and hide behind the reality that other things were being created.
Right.
Segregation in America is being created. Little white suburbs in America, so white folks could run out to these little
right.
homes and be away from black folks and create rot in the center of the cities, and no civilization can continue
and,
to endure if they allow their urban areas to rot, and that's what racism did in creating the suburban phenomenon.
And you would also admonish black brothers and sisters not to, you would also admonish white people, and most especially Jews, not to indict all black people for the remark, the Heinetown remark by Jesse Jackson.
Well, let's not deal with that. Let's deal with the reality.
What's wrong?
News media has indicted all black youth. When you see the crime perpetuated on the news media, and it's a black young man, it inevitably is an indictment of all black youth. Most crimes in America are committed by white folks.
And
85% of the related crimes and drugs are white folks. 85%. 85% of the drug-related crimes are by white folks. Most and the majority of the thievery and drunkenness is white folks.
Right.
But you do not have that image, and you do not have the whites going into the jail process and going into the jailhouse. We've got to understand racism in America and what it means.
Now, while you're watching this, consider the agony of those who would presume who are honestly trying, Professor Jeffries included, was asked to contribute, make his contribution to what should be in social studies textbooks for our children to read.
And
can you imagine, would you
like
to be a fly on the wall in this discussion involving Native Americans, Asians, Hispanics, African Americans, Latinos? I'm being called on. Hispanic is not an acceptable word. It's too broad.
But
it doesn't cover every culture.
Relax.
Who's this white guy think he is?
Relax.
Deciding what umbrella I fall under.
Still,
it's hard for me to relax. I get excited on important issues. And we'll be back in just a moment.
You wanted to say what, Professor?
I just wanted to clarify the issue in terms of the curriculum review that was put in place in 1988. Four consultants were asked to be a part of that process. To handle the look at the curriculum in terms of the Native American was a Professor White. To handle the curriculum over 100 documents, 150 documents, to handle it from the point of view of the Asian American was a professor from Hunter College. To handle it from the point of view of the Latino was also a professor from Hunter College, Dr. Fletcher Shelley Rodriguez. And I handled it from the African American. All of us agreed, after looking at 150 documents, that the curriculum of the state of New York, even though they had made a number of changes, was not good enough to take us into the 21st century where we need a global perspective on the world. It is as if only one person reviewed the curriculum of the state of New York, and only one person influenced the decisions to be made. They specifically singled out Len Jeffries and the African-American to create this hysteria. But I believe truth crushed to earth will rise again and again, stronger.
Over here, please. Hold it.
What I'd like to say is that I hear a lot of people calling Dr. Jeffries a bigot, a racist, an anti-this, and an anti-that. And nobody's doing their work. Nobody's going out there to read if what he's saying is out of his mind or if it has some foundation
or some data.
Before you call anybody anything, go do your homework.
Amen.
Yes.
Briefly, I'll speak to you. We'll be brief.
I'm interested in Dr. Jeffries' reaction to the story in, I think it's yesterday's time, regarding the curriculum success in the curriculum of inclusion
in the state of California
without apparently the nastiness and the antagonism that seems to result from his remarks.
Well, I think we need clarity on that. Nothing has resulted from my remarks. Even the speech that I gave that was played in Albany was played for 2 weeks, listened to by 100,000 people, including many Jewish, and there was not one letter, one response that was negative. It was after the vote of the Board of Regents, July 26th, when they had lost the struggle over curricular change,
when even Nathan Glaser moved over with the majority and left Arthur Schlesinger in terms of being in opposition, they had lost that struggle. July 26th, the Board of Regents voted to change the curriculum and institutionalize the process of bringing about change. Then they went into Project Chaos, and that's when the troubles over my remarks occurred. There has not been a, I've been making remarks like this for 20 years. I was involved in a search for the black family history in terms of enslavement, which came out of and was related to the Alex Haley Roots Project. And these books that you see here, the Dunham books on the slave trade, a four-volume study. We've been dealing with these things for 20 years. This is not something that just came up yesterday, but we've got to deal with it now in a more important way because Christopher Columbus is coming up next year in 92.
Are you there, caller?
Give this caller a chance.
Columbus
is coming up next year in 92.
Yes.
And I believe that people who understand what Columbus was all about and look at the underside of history.
Yes. May I share with you the ruckus that developed in Professor Jeffrey's hometown in New Jersey? Here are some folk from New York. This is how impassioned this has gotten. Show them this. You can continue to make your point.
The Jewish community stood with the black community against the people who came into that community.
Yes. Here are, incidentally, I don't think anyone was injured here, but it did get ugly, as you can see. And the right to march was granted by the New Jersey Supreme Court. Are you there, caller?
Phil.
Yeah.
This man is 100% right because black folks have been systematically brainwashed for over 400 years. But anytime a strong black man stands up to tell the truth, he threatens white America. He's also a threat to George Bush's so-called New World Order.
And we'll be back in just a moment. Yes, ma'am.
Professor Jeffries, I'm very saddened here today. I thought we were all God's children. But all I can say is, I wish you luck. May God be with you.
Yes. Well, we are all God's children, but the African has been subject to the most serious defamation of any peoples in the world, and we are making sure that will change.
That does not permit you to imply that the Jews were the major hand behind America's agonistic past.
I don't think he's ever implied that. And I'd like to see in this audience or in the outer audience that's listening and watching, produce one memo, one document, or one book to refute any of the things that he has stated in truth.
All right, yes, yes.
Professor Jeffries, I love the comment when you say some of the Jews are my best friends. We've heard that before. You're the worst kind of anti-Semite because you don't admit to being one, but your whole following is anti-Semitic.
Yes. Yes. Yes.
I'd like to say I'm a student in Dr. Jeffries' class, and I believe that if you all can just put aside our preconceived notions of racism and just listen to what he's saying, I think we'll all benefit.
Yes.
For those people who say that Dr. Jeffries is anti-Semitic, the prefix in the word Semite means Semite. Semite what? Semite black, Semite white. Jews are black and white people. And that's it.
Yeah.
I'd just like to say that we all can pray to God and hopefully our children will get the real history of the earth.
Phil, yes, let's get this one.
If we're allowed to investigate who was the head of the Gestapo for the Holocaust, why can't we find out who was the brain behind slavery?
That's right. Yes.
Why can't we work towards getting the curriculum in without knocking any other group?
And we'll be back in just a moment.
It comes to all kinds of charges of what we are and what we have not, and what we are and what we're supposed to be. Our response is to go the high road, to get into an understanding of who and what you are. Study in these books. We put in place a 50-week course in which we want our community to start researching and studying. So we move to a higher intellectual and spiritual road, knowing that we are the people who began the march of humankind in Africa. We are the people who raised it to its highest levels in Africa and continues to struggle in America for that particular truth. It's not a question of being anti-anybody, but it's a question of being pro-us. There is 100 million African bodies that come out of the death and destruction of the European experience, and we want to make sure that our ancestors hold us accountable for doing the right thing in reference to that. Other people talk about their Holocaust.
Service provided and promotional fees paid by the farmers.